on a Thursday morning, nothing gets you in the Olympic spirit like, well, that flame and this music.
I love that. The score was written 30 years ago when NBC's Joe Fryer sat down with the man behind it, Oscar winner John Williams.
It could be argued that legendary composer John Williams has appeared in more Olympics than most athletes, or at least his music has. His Olympic fanfare and theme debuted at the 84 Summer Games and remains vital to the Olympic soundtrack.
What did it mean for you to be asked to do something like that?
I think it meant a lot. You know, any connection with Olympics, I think, would make anyone very proud, certainly me.
For Williams, now 82, gold has come in the form of Oscars for his unforgettable scores in movies like Star Wars. But composing an Olympic theme is very different. Movies, after all, are scripted, so beats of music can dance in step with frames of video.
Hoopla, where are you?
For the Olympics, there is no script, so to Williams, the music had to feel more like a concert piece, one that starts with almost royal bravado.
I think my thoughts about the opening flourishes had to do with very general announcements of heraldry.
So in the Olympics, who's the royalty? Are the athletes the royalty?
Well, the athletes certainly are. They are the heroes and the heroines.
A minute into the piece, the music softens. Here, Williams can picture the athletes in that moment right before a race.
And you're at the start line and you're alone and it's quiet. And that's it, that the focus is so intense.
The pace then quickens as the race begins. The tension rises and the athletes run and skate and soar.
And then it does get loud.
And then it does get loud, that's right. Maybe if my imagination is right, as we approach the winning line, the athletes will again begin to start to hear the crowd. A flourish for the end, and a salute to the winner, and a salute to the competitors.
The piece itself is not easy to play, whether it's the National Symphony Orchestra or the Boston Pops. It can be an almost Olympian feat. Yet, 30 years later, no one has grown tired of the tune that made John Williams a part of something as iconic as the Olympics.
Team USA wins!
To be able to be some part of that thing is something, of course, I'm greatly gratified and greatly proud of.
For today, Joe Fryer, NBC News, Los Angeles.